Good evening. You're watching India Votes. Let's take a look at what's making headlines. Political heavyweights address multiple rallies across the country. Modi campaigns in Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, while Rahul attends rallies in Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra. Expelled JDU leader Sabir Ali formally joins BJP. No word on whether he will contest in the Lok Sabha polls. Expelled DMK leader Aragiri meets Finance Minister P. Chidambaram a day after his father offers to re-ally with Congress. And a special focus on the Maoist menace across the country and the challenges before security forces for an incident-free polls. Well, political campaigning is at its height with party leaders crisscrossing the country to reach out to the voters. In today's roadshows and rallies, Rahul Gandhi and Narendra Modi address crowds in Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh along with Chhattisgarh.
Friday marked a high-voltage political campaigning day in Madhya Pradesh. Both the Congress and the BJP had their star campaigners addressing the voters. Addressing a gathering in the Mandla district, the BJP's PM candidate Narendra Modi accused the UPA government of discriminating against the opposition rule states.
Delhi Sarkar, Rajyon ke prati dushmani ka vyavhar karne ka usko adhikar nahi hai. बड़े भाई छोटे भाई का व्यवहार ये दिल्ली को करने का अधिकार नहीं है सब बराबर के हैं ये संस्कृति हिंदुस्तान की राजनीति में लाना ये हमारा संकल्प है
Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi targeted the BJP, alleging that the then party had stalled crucial pro-poor bills in Parliament.
2004 में इन्होंने इंडिया शाइनिंग का गुब्बारा तैयार किया उसमें हवा भरी और उसको छोड़ दिया चुनाव से पहले 2009 में फिर वापस आए फिर से एक नया गुब्बारा इंडिया शाइनिंग और अब एक नया गुब्बारा आया है इसमें सिर्फ हवा नहीं भरी है इसमें दबाकर इन्होंने गैस भरी है और बहुत बड़ा गुब्बारा तैयार किया है गुजरात मॉडल का ऊपर और वो सबको दिख रहा है कि भैया गुब्बारा है और आने वाले समय में गरीब जनता कांग्रेस पार्टी के लोग इस गुब्बारे को फोड़ने वाले हैं
Earlier, Rahul Gandhi also held a rally in neighbouring Maharashtra, while Modi campaigned in the Maoist hotbed, Bastar region of Chhattisgarh.
क्या दिल्ली सरकार से 10 साल में आपको कोई फायदा हुआ है?
Meanwhile, Aam Aadmi Party convener Arvind Kejriwal started a three-day roadshow in Haryana. In his address, Kejriwal accused the state government of snatching away farmers' land for industrial projects.
हुड्डा जी ने जो कि कांग्रेस के मुख्यमंत्री हैं उन्होंने किसानों की जमीनें छीन-छीन के और रॉबर्ट वाड्रा को दे दी
इन लेस देन 10 डेज द कंट्री इज सेट टू विटनेस द कंट्रीज बिगेस्ट इलेक्टोरल बैटल व्हाइल द कॉन्टेस्ट इज बिटवीन ओल्ड राइवल्स कांग्रेस एंड बीजेपी द आम आदमी पार्टी इज एमिंग टू मेक अ हिस्टोरिकल डेब्यू ऑन द नेशनल सीन ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट राज्यसभा टीवी
An expelled JDU leader, Sabir Ali, joined the BJP today, around a week before the nation goes to elections. Sabir Ali was formally inducted in the party at an official ceremony at the BJP headquarters. He had been expelled from the JDU for making anti-party comments and praising BJP's prime ministerial nominee, Narendra Modi. The JDU had given him a ticket from Shiohar to contest the Lok Sabha polls after denying him a Rajya Sabha renomination recently.
मैं बीजेपी ज्वाइन किया और आज से बीजेपी का मुरैठा बांधकर पूरे देश में अकेलों के लिए जाऊंगा और जो सच बात है बताने का काम करूंगा 68 साल में जिस तरह ये धर्मनिरपेक्ष अपने आप को कांग्रेस और छोटी पार्टियां जो अपनी दुकान खोल रखी है वो लोगों की दुकान बंद करने का काम करूंगा
And moving on, senior Samajwadi Party leader Mohammad Azam Khan has invited rebel BJP veteran Jaswant Singh to join the party. Talking to media persons in Rampur on Thursday, Azam said, and I quote, "It was disheartening to know how such a veteran politician was not being awarded the respect and honour that he deserves but Samajwadi Party is ready to acknowledge his experience in politics, unquote. However, it was not clear if SP would offer Jaswant Singh a ticket, but he can prove to be a prized catch, especially if the party involves him in campaigning against the BJP stalwarts like Rajnath Singh in Lucknow or Narendra Modi in Varanasi. Jaswant Singh filed nominations as an independent candidate from Barmer in Rajasthan after BJP denied him a ticket. He has not officially quit the party yet. BJP too has not taken any action against the leader. Moving on in politics down south, expelled DMK leader M.K. Aragiri met Finance Minister P. Chidambaram earlier in the day. What transpired in the meeting is not known, but the meeting comes a day after his father, DMK chief Karunanidhi, offered an olive branch to the Congress. The party is ready to ally with its old partner again if it's ready to apologize. Reacting to the offer, the Congress too seems to be eager.
A day after he met half-sister Kanimuri, expelled DMK leader M.K. Aragiri met Finance Minister and Senior Congress Leader P. Chidambaram today. The two met at the Chennai airport today, but refused to clarify what they discussed. Ever since his suspension and dismissal from the party, Aragiri has been meeting leaders from parties in the NDA and Congress. But it is not clear what role will he play during the Lok Sabha polls after he decided not to contest. His open support to BJP's PM candidate Narendra Modi has not gone down well with his former party. Battling corruption charges against several leaders, Alagiri's father Karunanidhi is left without an ally for the big contest ahead. In a surprise move though, he approached DMK's former ally Congress. DMK President M. Karunanidhi offered to forgive and support Congress after the elections. He said, and I quote, "If the congressmen express regret and get back to their secular credentials, DMK will support them, not in terms of vote, but to change the evils that had gripped them and ready to forgive them," unquote. Congress was taken aback by the offer. But Chidambaram's reaction to it says Congress is ready to mingle again.
Congress Kachi Madachar Batra Padaki Varum and Ralla Solir Krab. Adanaka Vepe Tarikara. Congress Kachida Madachar Batra Ani Nudia Mayame Congress Kachida Madachar Bilirin the Congress Kachi Urunalam Belahi the Kadayad Madachar Bulla Kachi Yenda Ter the Lelaim Congress Kachi Adarita the Kadayad Nangal Nirkumidam.
During the rule of UPA 2, DMK leaders like A. Raja, D. Maran and Karunanidhi's daughter Kanimuri were allegedly involved in the 2G scam. All three were dropped from the cabinet. Raja and Kanimuri also spent time in jail. Even Karunanidhi's wife Dayalu Amal is facing questioning in the case. A cornered DMK had decided to call off the ties with Congress since then. If the alliance is revived, both Congress and DMK may prove to be a handful for Jayalalitha's AIADMK or BJP's six-party alliance. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And Saharanpur Congress candidate Imran Masood has apologized after stirring up a controversy with his remarks against BJP's prime ministerial nominee Narendra Modi. The video, which has now gone viral on the web, shows Masood's speech against Modi during an election rally in Saharanpur. A case has been registered against Masood in Dev Bad police station in the district. Both the Congress and the BJP have condemned Masood's remarks. BJP has asked the Election Commission to take strict note of it. The party will make an official complaint with the Election Commission on Saturday, seeking strong action against Masood's remarks.
Rashid Masood ke जो उम्मीदवार है उनके बेटे कांग्रेस के इमरान मसूद उन्होंने मोदी जी को मारने की और टुकड़े टुकड़े करने की धमकी दी है हम इसकी भर्त्सना करते हैं कांग्रेस कितना हिल गई है मोदी जी के जो समर्थन मिल रहा है उससे इसका यह सबूत है
देखिए अगर कुछ इस तरह की भाषा का इस्तेमाल किसी व्यक्ति के लिए हुआ है या उनके तो वो अच्छा नहीं है ये अशोभनीय है इस तरह के शब्दों का इस्तेमाल नहीं करना चाहिए
Now, as the Lok Sabha polls draw near, parties are busy finalizing their candidates in the different constituencies. All major parties have fielded their key contestants, but there are still some key seats left where both the BJP and the Congress have been left undecided. Take a look. All right, in fact, I'm being told we'll play out that package in just a bit. But before that, we're taking a very short break. Don't go anywhere. This is India Votes. Thanks for staying with us. You're watching India Votes. Now, just before the break, we were talking about candidates and constituencies and how the two major parties, the Congress and the BJP, have been left undecided on still some of the key seats. Have a look.
All eyes will be on Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh when the results come out on the 16th of May. Because this seat will see the only official PM nominee, Narendra Modi, contesting. No other party or alliance has decided who will be their choice for the top post, which makes Varanasi a key battle for all major political outfits. While Aam Aadmi Party convener Arvind Kejriwal has volunteered to challenge Modi in this holy town, the party hasn't come out with an official list yet. Congress too is taking its time to choose an appropriate candidate to challenge Modi.
निश्चित समय पर हम अपनी उम्मीदवारी घोषित करेंगे और निश्चिंत रहिए नरेंद्र मोदी को नाकों पसीना आएगा आसान नहीं जाएगा
Another key seat to watch out for will be Lucknow, where BJP President Rajnath Singh will be contesting. It's yet another key constituency where Congress is yet to decide a candidate. BJP too is waiting for the right candidates to take on the Congress bigwigs. In expected lines, Congress has pitched President Sonia Gandhi from Raebareli and Vice President Rahul Gandhi from Amethi. Both the constituencies are considered to be strongholds of the Congress. The party is holding discussions to finalize names for these two seats. The BJP has decided not to field Uma Bharti, a name that was doing the rounds for a possible contender against Sonia Gandhi. She got her preferred seat from Jhansi. However, there are talks of Smriti Irani taking on Rahul Gandhi from Amethi.
बुंदेलखंड की बेटी को यह मौका मिला कि वो इटली की बेटी को राजनीति से खदेड़ दे और ये हमारे क्षेत्र का बहुत बड़ा सम्मान है इस दृष्टि से
उमा भारती जी झांसी से ही चुनाव लड़ेंगी
अरविंद केजरीवाल्स आम आदमी पार्टी हैज पिक्ड कुमार विश्वास टू चैलेंज राहुल गांधी फ्रॉम अमेठी राहुल हैज रिप्रेजेंटेड दिस सीट इन द लोकसभा सिंस 2004 ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट राज्यसभा टीवी
And former Karnataka Chief Minister B.S. Yedurappa is back in the BJP, contesting from Shimoga. He hopes to strengthen his party's chances in the state. He faces a tough fight from JDS leader Geeta Sivakumar, though. Our correspondent Raj Kamal Rao spoke to him.
We have Mr. B.S. Yedurappa, former Chief Minister of Karnataka. He is back in BJP, contesting from Shimoga. Sir, now you have joined back in BJP. Many say that may be a disadvantage for the party in assembly elections because BJP had to lose. Now, do you see your entry into BJP as an advantage for the party?
You see, the NDTV, they have given the very clear picture about Karnataka. Yes. When I was the chief minister, we got about 43% votes. Now, we are expecting more than 46% of the vote according to NDTV survey and almost all the surveys. Now, we are hopeful of getting more than 20 seats in Karnataka.
Sir, this time you are contesting against Bangarappa's daughter. It is JDS versus BJP this time. Are you feeling competitive?
Yes, definitely. I am very comfortable. I am going to win very in margin votes.
Sir, is corruption issue in Karnataka? Because Congress party and BJP both are making claims against their attitude towards anti-corruption movements. So, what is the status in Karnataka now?
I don't want to discuss about all these things. And when I was the chief minister, I was very good popular programs to the people of Karnataka. They are happy about me. Mm. And you can inquire anybody in the state and any individuals. Mm. People are happy about the Bharatiya Janata Party performance.
That's what Yedurappa had to say to Rajya Sabha TV with camera person Manoj Raj Kamal Rao.
Now, any talk of violence against women takes center stage in the country only in the immediate aftermath of a gruesome incident of abuse. In the backdrop of the 16 December 2012 rape and murder, the government did step in to frame stronger, newer laws for protection of women on the roads and in the workplace. Here's a special report.
The night of December 16, 2012, the brutal gang rape and the victim's death set off a storm of sorts, raising the issue of women's safety like never before. Sexual harassment and rape to dowry deaths, child marriage, domestic violence, acid attacks, being branded a witch and more, it is an ugly list. yet it exists to this day in modern India, well into the 21st century. And she demands security.
Nirbhaya fund agar declare kiya gaya tha to uska istemal hona chahiye tha. Hum log ne prastav rakha tha ki one stop crisis intervention center bana dijiye, jile jile mein bana dijiye, taki agar kuch aisa hota hai to aurte jaake shikayat kar sake aur dusra ki unko puri tarah ka sahyog aur sahayata mil sake. और एक कैंपेन जो कि चूंकि मर्दों और लड़कों को भी बदलना पड़ेगा ये उनकी वजह से हो रहा है उनके सोच की वजह से हो रहा है तो उसको भी बदलने के लिए कहीं ना कहीं एक अवेयरनेस कैंपेन चला.
The Justice Verma Commission formed in the aftermath of 1612 suggested wide-ranging measures for protection of women. New laws were made for women's security at home and at work. Stricter punishment was laid down for anti-social elements, asset attackers and the like. Procedures were also tightened for victims of crime to get speedy justice. Under the Criminal Procedure Amendment Law 2013, an act of non-consensual sexual aggression will be considered rape. A government official who refuses to file a complaint related to sexual violence is liable to 2 years of rigorous imprisonment or penalty. A hospital employee is liable to 1 year rigorous imprisonment on refusal to treat a sexually assaulted victim.
आप देखिए पुलिस है, इनका attitude नहीं बदला, ये sensitized नहीं हुए हैं. Judiciary का भी रवैया वैसा ही है. अभी तक ये कहते हैं कि हमने fast track court बनाई है. अब एक fast track court एक district में अगर होगी, तो वो पूरे cases खत्म नहीं कर सकते. So इसलिए कानून वैसा बनना चाहिए जिससे कि प्रैक्टिकल हो सके.
But is enacting more laws enough? If yes, then why are crimes against women increasing by the day? NCRP figures say rape cases rose 57% between 2011-12 and 2012-13. The concern continues amid calls for much more on the lines of a sensitive police force and judiciary, and a broader approach to the malaise. Samina's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And you can catch that detailed report on the issue titled Respecting Her Rights. That's on Agenda 2014 tonight at 10:30. Now, carrying on with more election-related news, the threat of Maoists is one of the key security concerns gripping the nation these days. Like most of its neighbouring states, a large part of Orissa is under Maoist influence. Despite constant threats, there are some children in the state who are trying to write their own destinies. Here's a look at this report.
These children singing Gandhian prayers might seem like an ordinary sight, but a little insight into their lives will leave one surprised. Most of these children belong to the Maoist-affected tribes of Odisha. Some have lost their families in violence. Trying to leave behind the horror of terrorism, they have found a safe haven in the Kalinga Institute of Social Science in Bhubaneswar. It accommodates around 20,000 such children and provides them with free education and other basic necessities.
First, फैमिली रो एमती दु जण ठो जदे छुआ बेसी थी पहले ने जाउ छंती मु तो छटा थली गां रे सेते बेडे मते जेते बेडे मां बादी मान नेबा पे आसले सेते बेडे मो मान सपतड़े एमती गुडे देकी ए खटो तड़ पसी देथिले.
A BCom student from Malkangiri region narrated how he was kidnapped and trained at the Maoist camps. The Kalinga Institute is now helping him to leave behind the nightmares of AK-47 and fulfill his wish of becoming a chartered accountant.
2009 में हुआ था जब मैं समर छुट्टी में घर गया था उस टाइम उन लोग मुझको उठा के ले गया उसके बाद में मुझको ट्रेनिंग दी उन लोग एक मंथ ट्रेनिंग का ट्रेनिंग देने के बाद उन लोगों मुझको बंदूक दिया और बम सेटिंग करना.
कौन सी बंदूक चलाते थे क्या ट्रेनिंग दिया?
AK-47 चलाने.
After staying far from the mainstream society for years, these children are now trying to revive themselves. They're succeeding in finding their hidden talent. The under-13 rugby team has won the international championship from past 3 years, and the girls' team brought laurels by winning in London this time.
Medal हाथ जैसे आए ना बहुत खुश हूँ भगवान को सामंजी को धन्यवाद देने से कैसे कहूँगी ये भी मेरे मन में नहीं था
जब मेरे ऊपर भरोसा है लेकिन मैं बनूंगी उसकी साथ मेरे बहन और भैया को भी कुछ बनाना चाहती हूँ.
Along with sports and education, these children are also taught to be self-dependent. Skills like stitching, painting and toy making helps them earn some money, which they send to their families. Achyuta Samanta believes that complete education is the only solution to the Maoist problem.
जब वो लोग को ऐसे एनवायरनमेंट में ऐसे एम्बियंस में वो लोग को अच्छा एजुकेशन अच्छा लाइवलीहुड अच्छा खाना पीना रहना सब कुछ मिल जाएगा तो किस लिए वो लोग उसमें जाएंगे कि इस मॉडल यहाँ बहुत सक्सेस हुआ है अभी हम लोग का योजना है राज्य ओडिशा राज्य में 30 जिला में इसका ब्रांच खोलने के लिए
आउट ऑफ 30 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ऑफ ओडिशा अराउंड 20 आर मोस्ट अफेक्टेड द लाइफ इन दीज एरियाज आर वेरी डिफिकल्ट एंड पेनफुल एजुकेशन इज ओनली होप विच कैन हेल्प टू ब्रिंग अ चेंज Panchanand Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
Now, since the last few elections across the country, the Election Commission has been actively trying to raise awareness among voters to exercise their franchise. In a bid to boost turnouts during elections, the poll panel has now organised campaigns of folk theatre and street songs. Here's more on that.
As India is heading for the world's biggest democratic process, the Election Commission is doing its best to aware voters for greater participation. The poll panel has arranged campaigns like folk theatre and street songs to educate the importance of electoral process and encourage people to exercise their voting rights.
ये जो campaign election commission की तरफ से जो हमें दायित्व दिया गया है, इसमें जो है public को जो vote का अधिकार है, उसके बारे में जागरूक करने के लिए पब्लिक रिलेशन की ऑफिस से संगीत के माध्यम से लोगों को जागरूक किया जा रहा है
द मेन फोकस ऑफ दिस कैंपेन इज टू आस्क वोटर्स टू साइन अ वाउच टू वोट द कैंपेन आल्सो रिसीव्स द पॉजिटिव अटेंशन एंड पार्टिसिपेशन फ्रॉम द पीपल
जरूरी है ये क्योंकि जैसे गांव के लोग इन्हें नहीं जाते ज्यादातर वोट डालने के लिए जैसे नुक्कड़ नाटक देख लेते हैं तो समझते हैं कि हां नहीं जरूरी है वोट डालना हमारे
In the recent assembly polls in 5 states last year, turnout in all the states exceeded or equaled their previous records. This time too, the Election Commission hopes to encourage more and more footfalls at polling booths when the elections start on 7th of April. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
That's all we have for you in this edition of India Votes. We're taking a very short break. Don't go anywhere.